Hi students, now we are going to discussing about the warning of various disasters. So the warning should be basically the user specific, because the capacity of different users to withstand the impact of the disasters are different, and the warning has no values unless it reaches the end users at well in time, as well as the therefore a quick communication is very important at the warning stages. So if you take the warning measures of flood, the Central Water Commission, which issues the flood warning. So the state government, based on a particular local experience, they fixes a danger level for a river at certain places, such as near the cities or bridges. And the CWC issues the flood warning when the river level at a given place reaches or expected to reach the warning level, which is usually 1 meter below this danger level. So the CWC issues the flood warning in the form of the daily water level and flood forecast bulletins. So the state government, it set up a control room at the state as well as the district headquarters, and which received the warning from the flood forecasting centers of the CWC and transmit the warning to the affected areas. So the flood forecasting centers also broadcast the warning through this all India radio as well as the Doordarshan, and publish in newspapers for the wider publicity, and the warning are regularly updated as the new observations and forecast become available. And the warning of droughts is another one. So the drought, which develops slowly, and they are caused primarily by the continuous drought deficiency in the rainfall and other sources of the water, and this resulting situation needed to be watched very carefully, and effective relief action should be taken as soon as the sowing of seeds as well as standing crops being get affected by this adverse effect of this drought. So there is no warning system as such for the drought. However, the agriculture department as well as the revenue departments of the state, those remain watchful during the dry weather seasons, and the situation is monitored regularly, especially for those areas which are known to be drought prone due to the local climatic conditions and lowering of this scarcity of the groundwater, as well as the absence of the irrigation facilities. And another one is the warning towards the landslides and avalanches. So the heavy rain and heavy snowfalls which initiate these phenomena, and this occur more frequently in areas which are prone to these disasters due to the peculiar local geological features, such as the thickness of the soil or the rock. Therefore, the warning of rainfall or snowfall, which combined with careful watch by the local people, serve as an effective warning system or alerting system for the landslides and avalanches. And a local volunteer system is found to be a great benefit, and it is followed even in the developed countries. Another one is the warning of the forest fires. So the warning period of extreme dryness and combined with the absence of the rain or snow are the first indication of the hazard of the forest fires. The accumulation of combustible material on the ground adds to the problem. So in most cases in our country, the forest fires are due to the human carelessness. In such circumstances, a system of advance warning is not feasible, and usually the smoke or flame is the first warning. Next is our earthquake. As the earthquake cannot be forecast as yet, there is no warning system for the earthquake at present, and there are areas which are known to be prone to the earthquake activities, such as the areas have standing warning, so to say, and the country is divided into various zones, which representing the extent of the hazard, and depending on the number as well as the severity of the earthquake and that have occurred in the past. So the regions with a history of strong earthquake are more hazardous, and special care needed for those areas and for constructing the various structures, multi-story building and bridges and dams over those areas. And if areas which have experienced major earthquake activity in the past and remain undisturbed for a longer period, and this can be taken as a warning that an earthquake could occur somewhere and sometimes in those areas. But all these measures can be taken only as a general warning. Next is the another warning indication is continued occurrence of the tremors at a place, although it is not possible to be sure, because this tremors could be the releasing of the earth stress in a shorter burst of tremors. So it cannot be a major earthquake. It can be a short tremor. So in certain cases, some warning signals occur before an earthquake, such as unusual behavior of the animals as well as the reptiles, sudden lowering of the groundwater levels in the well, and widening of the existing natural cracks in the earth surface. Next is the warning of the cyclones. Cyclone warnings are issued by the India Meteorological Department. So through its area cyclone warning centers in Mumbai, Kolkata and Chennai, and cyclone warning centers in Hyderabad, Bhubaneswar and Visakhapatnam. In the first stage of the warning, a cyclone watch is maintained before and after, or pre-monsoon, during the pre-monsoon and post-monsoon months. And in the second stage, a cyclone alert is issued 48 hours before the expected commencement of a bad weather along the coast. And warning to the ports as well as the fishermen, which start earlier, and the ports display the warning by hoisting special visual signals to warn boats as well as the ships. And warning are expected regularly according to the progress of the cyclone, which is kept under constant observation through the satellite and radar equipments. So the cyclone warning are commenced 24 hours before the anticipated landfall, that is the anticipated time the cyclone is expected to hit the coast. And the cyclone warning are updated every hour and more frequently if the situation so demands. So the cyclone warning are sent to the ports, exports as well as railway, state and district authorities, and these issued to press the broadcast through the radios and television. For the quick and effective communication of cyclone warning to the field areas likely to be affected, a special system called the disaster warning system has been implemented in the coastal areas. And by this system, cyclone warning in the local language are broadcast, and the area cyclone warning center of IMD to the field area directly via the INSAT. And this warning is received through a small apparatus installed at the schools as well as the districts, offices or panchayats in the coastal regions. So these are references. Thank you.